Welcome back to Daytime. What a busy show we've had. And can we say we've saved the best for last? Maybe we have. Timm Holmes joins us again. We met a little while ago. Timm is the author of Peanut Butter and Dragon. I'm going to put that up just like that. Timm joins us. We're talking about Start a Story Young Writers Workshop.
Yeah, bit of a mouthful, but it has become a fantastic program that I now visit schools, libraries, and I do birthday parties as well, where in a small period of time, in a 75-minute program, we write a story as a group. It's aimed at primary age kids, so kids that are 4 to 9. So you're looking junior kindergarten to grade 2, and we have an absolute blast designing a story together.
I know when we were talking right before the show, you were talking about how important this is to you. Like this whole, the writing, the craft of it, the thought process, the end result, the beginning of it, and everything in between, it's really important to you.
I originally went to school to become a teacher. Life took me in a different direction, and this is kind of me tipping my, you know, tipping my toe back in the pond, as it were, having that chance to inspire young authors, young writers, young readers. Not everyone is going to become a writer, but reading and writing is so important. The building blocks of communication, and especially whether it's Twitter or whether it is you're writing a blog or you're talking to your boss at work. Communication is hugely important. So to build that early is fantastic.
Okay, really exciting. So now tell us how this came to be, this project. So
of course,
it's important
yeah.
to you, and then but how does it begin? How do you put it together?
This was actually a brainchild of myself and one of my boys' teachers. As I was getting Peanut Butter and Dragon put together, I was invited to read at Education Week at my boys' school, and this is back in May of 2016. So I did that, visited several classes, and my understanding at that time was I was to read the story and talk to the kids a little bit about how to, you know, about writing. And that was as vague as I had it. And so the way I chose to speak to them ended up being that I just told them how Peanut Butter and Dragon got put together.
Okay.
And all of the stories, Peanut Butter and Dragon is the first in what will be a series.
Yeah.
And all of the stories in the series are based on improvised bedtime stories I've told my two young boys. And the way I improvise it, I ask them what they want the beginning to be. And so in this case, it was, what do you want to hear about? It was a dragon. How do you want it to end? They chose a happy ending. And then it began, we filled out the middle. And I said, well, what would happen if a hungry dragon landed in the neighborhood? And that is how Peanut Butter and Dragon came to be.
Fun.
Using that same template and trying to keep it working with the my boy's teacher, we built a workshop that was age appropriate and curriculum appropriate for kids age 4 to 9. And Start a Story Young Writers Workshop was born.
Wow, is that interesting? So someone even as young as 4 can get involved in creating?
It is incredible. I had a group of junior kindergartens who wrote a story with us, and their story was a baby panda and a baby koala become friends by learning to take turns playing each other's favorite game. That came from the brains. I lead them from the beginning and to the end, but this all came from them. It was really incredible to see that happen.
Wow, so now you brought this thing with you. So
what
are we doing here?
This is the main tool that I use with the kids.
Okay.
And the way the workshop begins and what I frame it around is that we need to choose our beginning and our end. We need to know where we're starting and then where we're going.
Does that work when grown-ups write books?
It is one way. The way I talk to the kids about it and what I say is, it's my way. Every writer
That's
you talk to them,
point.
They have a different way to do it.
That's a good point.
This is, and I'm very open with them, that this is my way. You may find another way in the future as you begin to continue to write, but this is my way. So, and that's all I can really present to them,
is
what I know. So I give them the beginning, I give them the end, so then we know where we're going.
So the beginning, Captain Cake Pirate Kitty is on the hunt for buried treasure with her crew of critters. Okay, does that mean like bugs? Critters?
No, we got, there's a raccoon, there's Ash Squirrel, there's Oops Octopus, there's a whole crew of these people. This
I
is
like
actually,
that.
For the purposes of our demonstration today, because I'm going to invite you to actually write a story today.
Oh, I can do that. And then the end is they find a new friend, Oops Octopus.
They find their new friend, Oops Octopus. So what happens is
I'm
normally these choices
are... freaking me out.
No, this is it. There are kids who are afraid. And it's wonderful. You always have the 5 kids that are super excited and they want to give every answer. They want to have every choice. But the win and the satisfaction I get is when that one kid who didn't want to say anything has that one idea that
all
sort
right,
of
well, we've got 2
pulls
minutes.
It all together.
What do you want me to do?
So the first thing we're going to do is normally these choices are made together with the kids.
Okay, so, let's pretend
we did the purposes of demo, we've done it together.
Sure.
Again, I'm going to give you some choices here. These choices, again, would come out of discussion with the kids.
Okay.
I wouldn't be presenting these ideas to you,
we're
but
discussing.
For the purposes of this, we're going to do it. So without further ado, Your choice. Captain Kidd, Pirate Kitty, looking for buried treasure. What's the first thing that's going to happen? Are they going to set sail together on their mighty ship, the Litter Box?
Mm-hmm.
Is the crew going to walk the path on their map together? Or is the crew going to decide to race each other to be the first
Let's
to the
race.
Treasure?
Let's
we're going to race.
Yeah, we're
going to
race.
All right, so we're going to race.
Okay, I like
All
that.
Right.
Okay, so now we're racing.
We're racing.
Cool.
So then a storm is going to get in the way. Or the crew is going to get lost. Or a scary creature tries to stop
No, let's
them.
Go for a storm.
Storm.
Yeah.
All right.
But nobody gets hurt. There's a storm, but nobody
There's
gets hurt.
Nobody okay. gets. So the third and final choice we're going to make as we make our way to the end. Today, Captain Cake Pirate Kitty saves the day. Cackle's Crow saves the day. Or Mother Mouse saves the
Mother
day.
Mother Mouse.
Mother Mouse.
She must be little. I like that.
Mother Mouse
people,
saves the day.
People winning.
Now, in a real workshop, each of these choices, as we make them, we dig for details. We fill in all of the aspects. They're going to race. Okay, how do they race? Are they getting in cars? Are they flying? There's a storm. What kind of storm? Is it on an ocean? Are they trapped on a mountain?
I want everyone, just before, I know we want to finish this, but if somebody wants to contact you to do this, whether it's in their school or at their party, where can they find the information?
The best place is my website that I've set up specifically for this is startastory.onuniverse.com.
Beautiful. And you can meet the author this Saturday, July 28th. We're talking about this author, Timm Holmes, at Chapters South Keys from 11 to 3.
And I'll be able to talk about the book and the workshop there.
The book and the workshop, and we're going to figure out the storm and the race and the mouse, and in the end, they find their friend.
And we'll get it all done. Have a
Thank
good time.
Thank you so much, and we're going to see you on daytime tomorrow.